Now we are going to discuss about prostaglandin. First, we will discuss on synthesis of the prostaglandin. Basically, linoleic acid is your dietary precursor for the synthesis of prostaglandin. Okay, linoleic acid is desaturated and elongated to form your arachidonic acid, and arachidonic acid is the basic immediate precursor of the prostaglandin. Okay, arachidonic acid is formed from linoleic acid. Linoleic acid converted into arachidonic acid, and this arachidonic acid will be converted into prostaglandin. Clear? And we have taken linoleic acid in our diet. Now, this arachidonic acid is incorporated into membrane-bound phospholipid. Okay. Now, coming to this, how prostaglandin has been formed. So, one enzyme that is known as phospholipase A2, phospholipase A2 will work on this phospholipid, and it will convert phospholipid into your arachidonic acid. And on this arachidonic acid, prostaglandin H synthase will work, which will convert this arachidonic acid into your prostaglandin S2. So, the name is prostaglandin H synthase. And this prostaglandin S synthase basically contains two components, that is, one is cyclooxygenase and other is peroxidase. And this cyclooxygenase is inhibited by your aspirin. Okay, so this is the basic of the synthesis of prostaglandin. Now coming to the functions of prostaglandin. First, we will discuss effect on CBS. So prostaglandin is prostacycline, a chemical compound which is formed from prostaglandin. Okay, and this prostacycline, which is formed from prostaglandin, is a vasodilator and also inhibits platelet aggregation. So it is protective. It has protective effect on vessels wall against the deposition of platelets, which may lead to the formation of embolism. Okay. Now coming to the effect on uterus and ovary. PGF2, prostaglandin F2, it is used for medical termination of pregnancy. It is also used to induce labor, and some prostaglandin are also involved in LH-induced ovulation. Okay, so medical termination of pregnancy, labor, and LH-induced ovulation. Prostaglandin also lead to the formation of leukotrienes, and these are basically formed from arachidonic acid. Okay, and leukotrienes are the most potent chemotactic agent. And last one is that mechanism of action of prostaglandin. It is through your GPCR, G protein coupled receptor. Okay, so this was a rapid revision. Thank you.